Hi guys, welcome in another video. This video is a part two of two video series in which I show you how to create very simple Android Studio plugin. In the previous video, I showed you how to create a plugin which gets a list of all connected devices using ADB and shows very simple notification in Android Studio. If you haven't seen it, check it out, the link will be somewhere on the screen. In this video, we will finish our plugin. I will show you how to create a plugin which allows you to toggle layout bands option from tools menu in Android Studio on all connected emulators and of course also on all connected physical devices. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, but first, how to enable some developer option from ADB? Well, as far as I know, most developer options cannot be enabled using ADB, but fortunately, Show Layout Bands, so this option, is one of the exceptions. And I found out about it thanks to this Stack Overflow answer, which shows that to show layout bands, you can use this ADB command. Using this command, we set the back layout property to true, and then we have to poke the system properties to see the changes. This enigmatic number at the end is the sysprop transaction, is explained at the very bottom of this answer. And this flag is used by settings app to refresh the setting. Okay, so let's copy it and find out if it works. We first set the back layout property to true and then poke system properties. And as you can see, well, the option was not refreshed, but show layout bounds works. Okay, and now we can also disable it, of course, by resetting this flag and then also refreshing settings. Okay, so now let's use this command in our plugin. In the previous video, we created a plugin where we got the list of all connected devices using ADB. And we displayed a notification with the information about how many devices are currently connected. So now we will modify this plugin to finally show the layout bounds. First, we get the devices list and I will check if this list is not empty. So I will use takeIf function and inside this function I will use isNotEmpty. So now the result of this operation will be null if no device is connected or devices list if there is at least one device connected. After that, I will iterate over this list and for each connected device, I will execute ADB command just in a second. And then if no device is connected, we will use the run block and show the notification with the message as we did earlier. And we will remove if else block since we no longer need it. Okay, we iterate over each connected device. Now we want to execute this ADB shell command. So I will rename it to device so the code will be a bit more readable. And now how to execute ADB command on this device? Well, fairly easy. All we have to do is to call device execute shell command. And this function takes two parameters. First is our command. We will set the back layout property to true. And after that, we will refresh this setting. Okay, and the last parameter that we need to pass is the output receiver. And since we don't want to listen to the ADB response, we will just pass null output receiver. Okay, let's find out if it actually works. So I will build my plugin and we will install this plugin in Android Studio once again. Okay, so our plugin was built and now we will install it once more in the plugin sections in preferences of Android Studio. As you might saw in the previous video, our jar is in build libs folder and once I click it, I have to restart the IDE to apply the changes in plugin. Okay, so after Android Studio restarted, changes in plugin was applied. Now, when I click Show Layout Bounds option in Tools menu, as you can see, layout bounds appear. And after I disable it, in developer options and once again use our plugin. So I will click show layout bounds in tools menu. As you can see, layout bounds appear. But I cannot hide layout bounds options using this plugin. I still have to do it in developer's option. So let's enhance our plugin a little bit. But instead of adding another option in tools menu, hide layout bounds, let's make our plugin detect if layout bounds are enabled and then toggle this option on all connected devices. Okay, so we are back in IntelliJ and now we want to modify our show layout bounds action and make it toggle layout bounds action. Okay, so first let's take this part and move it to the extension function so it will be more readable. So I will cut this piece of code and create a new extension function called set layout bounds. And this function will take the parameter, and this parameter will allow us to use this function to both enable and disable show layout bounds option. So I will pass this enable parameter here. Okay, but how to determine if layout bounds option is already enabled? Well, it's fairly easy to do that. All we have to do is to execute another show command, but this time we don't want to set property debug layout, but get the current value of the debug layout property. How to do it? Well, we'll call the execute shell command once more, and our command will be get prop debug layout. But now we of course want to listen what was the response. And to do it, I will create a new class called single line receiver, which will process the first line of the response. Okay, we will create new class in the same file just for the simplicity's sake and make this receiver inherit from multiline receiver class. And because we inherit from multiline receiver, we have to implement two functions. First is the function process new lines, which gives us all the lines from the response. As our class name says, we only want to process the first line, and then we don't want to listen to anything else. Okay, so how to do it? We'll take the lines, then we will get first value or null if the list is empty, and if the list was not empty, we now want to pass this value, this first line. We want this first line to be passed here. We want it to be called, well, like this. We want to pass single line receiver and here execute set layout bounds with the enable flag, which will be processed from this function. To do it, we have to pass as a parameter to this class a function. So I will declare private value process first line parameter. And this parameter will be a function. And the parameter of this function will be our response. Well, actually the first line of the response. And its type will be string, and it will return an unit. Okay, so what now? Now we want to pass our first line to the process first line function. And now we can use this first line to determine if layout bounds are currently enabled and to set the exact opposite state. But first, let's check what get prop debug layout actually returns when we run this command. So here I have my emulator connected and it has show layout bounds option disabled. And when I run this command, I have to add ADB show here. And when I run this command, as you can see, I receive false. And after I enable this option, and run this command once more, I will receive true. This first line is very easy to process. All we have to do is to just convert it to Boolean. And since we want to toggle the state of layout bands, we will use not function to set the exact opposite state. Okay, and I believe that's... Oh, and one last thing. We also need to implement isCancelled function. And since we want to just process the first line, the easier way is to just add a flag, and this flag will be called cancelled and will be false initially. And after first line is processed, this flag will be set to true. And we will use this flag as a state of is cancelled. Okay, so that will be all in toggle layout bounds action. The last thing before we build our plugin and check in Android Studio if it works is to modify the displayed text and the description of our action. So I will replace show with toggle, and also I will modify the ID. And after that, we can build our plugin and reinstall it in Android Studio, restart Android Studio, and then we can see if our plugin works. And that will be our finished product. Okay, so I reinstalled plugin after making our changes, and I restarted Android Studio, and as you can see, plugin update was installed. And now in the tools menu, we can see toggle layout bounds option instead of show layout bounds option. So now let's see if it actually works. And when I click toggle, the layout bounds appear, and after I click toggle once more, they disappear. And of course I can also trigger this action using a keyboard shortcut like this, and just by searching the name of an action, as you can see here. Okay, and that will be all in this tutorial. Thank you all for watching. I hope this tutorial was helpful and will inspire you to create the same or maybe very similar plugin. If you want to watch more videos like this, click the subscribe button, and hopefully we will see each other in the next video. Thank you, bye.